月吧，应当是的一系列的演讲。我们有其他的方面的这个活动，包括人工智能啊种种。但是今天是请了，就是很高兴请了顾远峰在Stony Brook的教授来讲这个关于图像处理这个问题。顾远峰是我从前的哈佛的学生，在1999年我们就开始做这个公型理论应用在图像处理。这20多年来发展了不少工具，不少的结果。我很高兴看到这些成果。当时我就主要就想图像处理一定跟那个二维的公型有关，因为呢是一个古老的一个方法。以后数学上尤其几何上有很多工具都能够用在这个 computer science 里边。尤其最近这个我们看的那个 optimal transportation 种种都跟几何有关。所以我希望听众也能够想想看几何跟那个图像处理跟其他的那个计算机的关系。我希望我们就在国内这个研究能够技术的发展能够完成。这个显峰讲得很好，所以我希望你鼓励你们多听听他讲的，也看看他写的文章。好，显峰你讲吧。
好，谢谢邱先生。好的。那我们下面开始讲课哈。好，我们就是先用英语汉语同时讲是吧，先用英语讲一遍，然后用汉语再解释一下。So today we cover algebraic topology. So basically we focus on two topics. One is a fundamental group, one is a covering space. So topology is really interesting, very useful in practice as well. So this is a famous drawing by Eicher. Okay, we see some ants climbing, crawling on a Mobius band. So this picture shows that the Mobius band actually has only one side. So if we trace the ant, then you can go from one side to the other side. So if you trace the boundary, you see the whole Mobius band has only one boundary. So therefore, for this kind of shape, we cannot differentiate outside inside. Then we say this shape is non-orientable. In reality, so all the surfaces actually is the boundary for some solid. So then we can tell which side is inside, which side is outside. So therefore, we focus more on the oriented surface, like the one shown here. But suppose we are some ants, crawling on the surface. We do not have the view for R3. Then how can we tell the difference between these two shapes? So for human being, we can see a hole here. So therefore, we can tell the difference very easily. But for the ants, ants has only very narrow field of view, and the ants cannot jump to the R3, so he cannot see this hole. Is there any intrinsic way to tell the existence of such kind of hole? So that's the fundamental question we are facing. Okay, 就是说，假如我们是一只蚂蚁，生活在这个曲面的表面上，然后人类的话呢，因为可以看到这个洞，是吧？这个洞的话，实际是这个曲面和 R3 之间的一个相对的关系。但对于这个蚂蚁来讲的话呢，它一辈子生活在曲面上，它没有三维的概念，所以它也不能跳出来看到这个洞，是吧？那么这个蚂蚁有没有什么非常本质的这个方法，能感受到这两个形状的不同？所以就是说，这个问题究竟是内蕴的还是外蕴的？这个洞呢，是这个曲面本身的性质啊，还是这个曲面和它所处的R3空间的一个相对关系？这是这个问题的哲学意义，是吧 ？Okay, so the key idea is as follows. So if the ant is intelligent enough, then we can trace different loops on the surface. Okay, such like this kind of loop, this kind of loop. So if the shape is something like this, then the ant can tell all the loops can shrink to a point. So therefore, For this one, some loops cannot shrink to the point, okay, on the surface. So this gives us the key difference between these two shapes, okay? So if we formulate this idea rigorously, we will get the fundamental group idea. 就说如果这个昆虫，它足够聪明的话，那么它无法跳离这个曲面，但它可以在这曲面上画一些圈，然后呢，逐渐变这些圈，看这些圈的话，能在曲面上逐渐缩成一个点。那么这个小女孩的一个曲面的话呢，所有的圈都能缩成点。但是这个小猫的曲面的话，我们画出这样的圈和这样的圈啊，这个圈无论你怎么缩，最后的话它没有办法缩成一个点。就是从那么这个圈的话呢，实际是不需要R3 的信息是吧？只需要曲面本身的信息。那么把这个想法严密化，发展成一套严格的数学理论，就是同轮群的想法。Okay. So from topology, we know that all the oriented compact surfaces can be classified by their genus G and the number of boundaries B. So we use GB to present the topological type for any oriented surface.就说对于所有可定向的然后紧的曲面他们可以根据这个规格还有这个边界的数目来进行分类。所谓规格就是有多少个 handle, 这边有多少环柄啊，这是一个环柄，这是环柄啊，这个小女孩的话没有环柄。所以的话对于曲面拓扑来讲的话这个可定向性然后规格的数目然后这个边界的数目这三个量的话完全决定了它拓扑。So here we see some example using computational topology method. We can locate the handle. Okay, so for each handle, we get two loops. One is the red loop, one is a green loop. Okay, the red one, the green one. So you can imagine that the green curve can shrink to a point. Okay, in the interior solid, but the red loops cannot.And the red loop can shrink to a point in the exterior okay, space, but cannot shrink to a point in the interior space. So we call all the red loops as a tunnel loops and the green loops as a handle loops. Detecting such kind of loops are very crucial. 就说给定一个封闭曲面，一个封闭曲面的话呢，把三维空间分成两部分，一部分是外部，一部分是内部。然后的话呢，它每个环柄上有两个圈这个红圈和绿圈是吧？这个红圈的话呢，在外部可以缩成一个点，但是在内部它没有办法缩成一个点。这个绿圈正好相反，这绿圈的话呢，在内部能缩成一个点，在外部呢没法缩成一个点。所以的话呢，我们把这红圈称为是隧道圈 （tunnel loop）， 把这绿圈呢称为是环柄圈是吧 （handle loop）。那么这个计算拓扑的话呢，第一个任务当然是找到这些圈是吧？这个 handle loop、tunnel loop。So why are they useful? Okay, they are very, very valuable for real applications. Okay, especially for medical imaging. So here we show some kind of colon surface. For colon cancer detection, we capture colon using CT image. Then we do image segmentation. And from segmented image, we can reconstruct the surface for the colons. But due to the segmentation error,then the reconstructed surface has a lot of fake handles. So therefore, there are a lot of small tunnels there. It's extremely difficult for human eyes to find them. But then without correct topology, we cannot go further. So how can we detect such kind of fake handles? It's called a topological denoise. Okay? 就是说在医学图像上的话呢，我们经常需要通过医学图像来重建器官的曲面。这边显示的是一段这个人的大肠是吧？直肠曲面。那么我们用 CT 得到的是这个直肠的很多截片，然后的话呢，用这个图像 segmentation 的方法，把这个每个平面、每个图像分成内部和外部，然后在边缘处的话呢，我们建立这个曲面。但是图像处理的话呢，经常有大量的错误。那么一个像素出错的话呢，就会使这个整体的曲面的拓扑发生错误。所以大肠的话呢，它本身是个 cylinder 是吧？本身是一个桶状的，它的拓扑非常简单。但是的话，你的数值处理之后的话呢，有很多虚假的这种 handle 和 tunnel。那么这些虚假的地方呢，用人眼非常难以看到的。所以的话，我们必须要用这个计算拓扑的方法，找到这些特殊的一个圈儿。OK， So now I can show you the real data. So for this guy, okay, this is the real data reconstructed from a medical image. So then we see that we get a genius 20. But for human colon, we know that, okay, it should be cylinder, right? There should be no genus. But then if we're using human eye, okay, to detect the fake handle, fake tunnel, it's highly difficult, okay? So basically, if we turn on the triangulation, you see, okay, there's huge amount of vertices, triangles, then it's really hard to manually find the mistake, okay? But using computer, you can very easily, okay, find the error, okay? So that one showing here, you see here we detect fake tunnels and loops, okay, around this appendix area, okay? 就说这个用人眼来看这个曲面，然后去找这些出错的地方呢，非常困难。它很多这个很多小的handle的话，藏在这个曲面的内部。然后的话呢，如果不用自动的方法的话，这个对于真人来讲的话，几乎是没有可能找出来的。但是用计算机这个算法，可以很容易就找到这些虚假的地方，图像 reconstruction 出错的地方。OK，所以的话这个这项技术的话。 在一些图像上用的非常的普遍，OK，像西门子啊、GE啊，他们这个虚拟的这个癌症检测技术中都用到这个特步计算的方法。OK，so in real life, this topological denoise, okay, has been used a lot for all the real applications, okay, in reality, and has adopted by by Siemens and GE. And all the major medical imaging device companies. Okay, so today we will cover the theoretic foundation for such kind of phenomena. Okay, and the computational method. So today we will introduce five major topological computational methods. Then after this class, we will give you some code library. You are encouraged, okay, to implement, okay, by yourself. 所以这次课的话呢，我们会给大家一些基本的这个程序库，然后大家的话呢，可以把这堂课讲的这个五种算法，特别基本的计算特步算法加以实现，是吧？这个在使用中还是有很大的应用价值啊。OK， so then the philosophy for algebraic topology is as follows. So basically, we have a topological space like manifolds, and we can define some special groups. Okay.Associated with this manifold. And then, okay, the algebraic structure, the group structure can reflect, okay, the topological properties of the space. So the, basically, we take a photo for topology, but using the algebraic image. Then, so this process will lose some information, but also reduce the difficulty to process. So in a more rigorous language,We have the category for topological space and the homeomorphism. And we have another category, the groups and the homeomorphism. Then we have functor between those two categories, okay? Then this category is computable, okay? We can use in computer to process. So this category is hard to compute and hard to be imagined. So 代数拓扑的这个主要的哲学思想是这样的。就说给了一个拓扑空间，我们在这个空间上定义各种各样的群，然后的话呢，通过研究这些群的性质，我们来反映出这个空间的拓扑性质。那换句话说，我们为这个拓扑空间拍了一张照片，这个照片的底片的话呢，是代数的。那代数这个词和这个算法这个词是同源的，它都是可计算的一个意思，是吧？代数的好处的话，就说可以用计算机来处理。那拓扑问题的话呢，很复杂，很多时候只能。依靠人类的想象是吧？但是如果你有个 concrete 能计算的东西的话，就把这个问题难度降低了。但是的话呢，这个过程的话呢，它没有办法把所有的结构完全保持，所以它会丧失掉一些信息是吧？所以这是代数拓扑的这个能力的一个缺陷，OK， 所以这是它背后的一个总体的思想。OK， so The first important group is called a fundamental group. Okay. So the idea is that we consider all the loops, okay, on the surface. Then we classify the loops by homotopy. Okay, then all the homotopy classes form a special group. Okay, then by understanding the structure for this group, we can get some property of the surface. Okay. 所以最重要的就是这个所谓基本群的概念。那基本群呢，它是这样的：我们先在曲面上固定一个点，然后呢，考察这个点的所有的曲线、所有的圈儿。然后这些圈儿的话呢，在同轮的意义下进行分类。那么这些同轮类的话呢，构成一个代数结构，叫所谓的这个群，是吧 ？OK， 嗯。然后用这个群的话呢，我们可以看到。这个原来的拓扑的一些信息是吧？这很不好意思，因为今天的话是美国的独立日，所以这个窗外的话很多人在放鞭炮，所以大家听到有很多这个噪音是吧？这个大家有问题的话随时通过 chat 那个告诉我是吧 ？OK， 这今天也是特别 special 的一个日子是吧 ？OK， 我把这个麦克风调一下啊。OK， 那么什么叫这个同轮呢？这边我们显示的一个实例是吧？就说我们得到一条这个映射，得到一个映射是吧？从01这个单位区间映到曲面上，得到曲面上的一条路径，然后的话呢？如果呢，我们能把这个路径从一条逐渐的变到另外一条，不离开这个曲面，我们说这两个曲线是同轮的。Okay, so this picture shows the definition for homotopy. So intuitively, we have a different path, okay, connecting the same point. If we can deform, okay, the first path, okay, to the second one, gamma 0 to gamma 1, okay, continuously, and without leaving a space, then we say those two loops, two curves.Homotopic to each other. Okay, then we can see the rigorous definition. So a curve is a continuous map from unit interval to the surface. A closed curve, okay, the loop, okay, is a curve such that the starting point, okay, and the ending point coincide. Okay, then we say two loops are homotopic. So if there is a one family of loops, okay, one family of curves, okay.The first curve is a gamma 1, the second curve is a gamma 2, and in the middle, we get a smooth deformation from one to the other. Okay. 这是同轮的这个数学定义是吧？这个一条曲线实际是一个连续映射，从单位区间这个映到曲面上。那一个圈或者一个封闭曲线，就说这个曲线的起点和终点重合，都等于一个 base point 是吧？一个基点 P， 那么如果给定两个曲线，那连接它们的话呢，有一轴曲线，这一轴曲线从第一个曲线开始，到第二曲线终了是吧？然后的话呢，当我们变换头一个这个参数的时候，会得到不同的光滑的曲线。如果这个映射整体存在的话呢，我们说这两条曲线彼此是同轮等价的。OK， then the homotopy relation is an equivalence relation， so we can easily show that。If gamma sub 1 is homotopic to gamma sub 2, then gamma sub 2 is homotopic to gamma sub 1. Okay. So therefore, all the loops through a base point can be classified by this homotopy relation. Okay. 就是说非常容易证明，如果第一条曲线和第二条曲线同轮，当且仅当第二条曲线和第一条曲线同轮。所以的话呢，我们可以把这个曲面上所有的圈根据同轮分类。每个类的话呢，用这个方括号来表示，是吧 ？OK， 然后的话呢，我们定义这个所谓的这个两个圈的一个乘积，是吧？那么，和一个圈的逆，是吧？这个图的话呢，显示这个圈的逆，就说给了一个圈 ，OK， 它是从这边开始走，然后的话，走过来，走到这边，是吧 ？OK， 那么，它的逆的话呢，就是，方向取反。 我不知道这个大家能不能看到的鼠标上 ，OK， 就是从这边走，这是开始的圈的，这么走 ，OK。然后的话呢，它的逆的话呢是方向取反，它的逆是方向这样走是吧 ？OK。那么数学表示的话呢，就是它的逆的 t 等于伽马一减 t 是吧 ？OK。So this picture shows the inverse for a loop. So basically, the inverse of a loop just means we take the inverse direction. Okay, we reverse the orientation. Okay, then mathematically, that means we change gamma inverse t equal to gamma 1 minus t. Okay, so this defines the inverse. So here we define the product. Okay, basically, suppose we have two loops, gamma now and gamma 1.Okay. Then basically, we follow the first. Okay, gamma now. Okay, first. Then we go along with gamma one. So basically, product means a concatenation. Okay. 那么这幅图的话呢，显示的是两个圈的乘积，是吧？两圈的乘积的话呢，就是我先沿第一个圈走，然后回到起点，然后从起点再沿着第二个圈走，所以就是两个圈首尾相连，得到一个大圈啊。这个大圈的话被称为两个圈的这个乘积是吧？那么数学上看的话呢，就说给定两个圈，然后呢我构造一个大圈，这个大圈呢这个前一半的话呢是沿着第一个圈走，后一半呢沿第二个圈走，首尾相连。So this is the mathematical definition for the product. So for the first half, we go along the first loop. And for the second, this should be one, okay?For the second part, we go along with the second loop. So then we define the inverse, we define the product. So therefore, under this product relation, we can define the fundamental group for the surface. So this is the formal definition. So given a topological space, and we fix a base point P, and we consider all the loops, okay, through P, which is denoted as gamma. Okay, then we classify gamma.Using homotopy relation here, the product is defined as okay this way. Given two loop, okay, then we take the product of the loop. The homotopy class of this product is defined as the product for the classes. Okay, then the unit element actually is a single point, just P itself. Okay, so E actually equal to gamma T for arbitrary T. So this kind of special curve.It's called the element, okay, unit element. So the inverse is defined as before. Then we can show that all the homotopy classes of loops, okay, through a fixed point under this product operator form a group, okay? So this group is called a fundamental group. 那这边呢，我们给了基本群的一个严格定义，就说我们给了一个拓扑空间是吧？当然大多情况下是流行是道路连通的。然后呢，我们固定这个空间中的一个基点 P， 然后我们考察固定点所有的圈，将这些圈进行分类，根据同轮关系进行分类。然后的话呢，我们用圈乘积的类来定义类的积是吧？然后呢，我们用这个圈的逆的类定义类的逆是吧？然后我们可以看有一种特殊的圈，这个圈就是一直没有走。它一直等于那个 P 那个点，一直在 P 点上哈、啊。这样的圈的话呢，构成了所谓的 OK unit element。那么换句话说，任何一个圈在曲面上是吧？它呢如果能缩成一个点 ，OK， 它如果能渐渐缩成一个点，那它都属于这个类的。所以的话呢，这个 E 呢就代表所有能缩成点的那些圈 OK， 那可以证明所有的这些通轮类的话呢，构成了一个群。这个群被称为曲面的基本群 ，OK， 所以这是曲面基本群的确切定义 ，OK，OK，then how can we using computer to represent a fundamental group？OK，、okay? then how can we really compute manipulate？OK，so、okay? we can represent a fundamental group symbolically，OK，using something called a word group。So for word group, basically just like English word, we have letters, okay, A, B, C, D, through Z. So all the words are generated, okay, by these letters, or can be represented as a string or letters. So each word can be read on as a string of characters. Okay, so then each of them is one element in the generator. Okay, then the power ei here is an integer. Okay, could be positive, could be zero, could be negative. A special word, okay, has no letter, is called the unit element. So the product of two words is just a concatenation. So suppose this is the first word, this is the second word, then their product, okay, basically you just put them together, form a bigger string, okay? Then the inverse for word, actually you inverse the order, okay, or the letters, and you negate, okay, all the powers, okay? So under second definition, all the words form a group, freely generated group, okay? 就说这个基本群很抽象，那你计算机上如何表示，如何处理？那么我们有这个用符号的方法来进行表示，是吧？我们考察这个英语构成的词汇，这个词汇的话呢，都是由字母生成的。那么就说任何一个词汇的话呢，可以表示成一串的字母，是吧？所以的话呢，我们把这个字母称为生成元，是吧？A B C D 一直到 Z 称为生成元，是吧？那么一个词的话呢，可以看成是一串字母，一串生成元，是吧？那么这边的话，每一个 sub i 是吧，都属于这个生成元，但它还有个 power， 这个 power 什么意思呢？就说如果你这个字符串中连续出现了三个 a 是吧，那你可以就写成 a 的 cube， OK。然后的话呢，所以所有的词都可以这么表示，对吧？那有的词的话，它什么都没有，它本身是空的，这种词被称为是单位元。那么给这两个词，第一个词有 n 个字母上，第二个词有 n 二个字母，你把这两个词拼起来，那么得到一个更大的词上，这个拼接动作被称为乘积。那给了一个词，那它的幂的话呢，就是把它 letter 先幂序。然后把它这个指数的话呢，取负，这样得到一个新的词，是吧？那么在这些运算之下的话呢，这些词构成一个自由生成的群，被称为词群。Okay. That way we try to use the word group to represent fundamental group. But the fundamental group has a richer structure, more complicated nature there. Okay. So in general, this group is not a building, not a community. Okay, we will show this. Okay, in the future. Okay. So here, we introduce something called a relation. So relation, actually are special words. Okay, whenever you see such kind of words, you can just delete them from the word. Okay. Okay. So basically, given M relations, we define a special equivalence relation between two words. So given two words.We say they are equivalent if we can transform one word to the other word by the following two elementary transformation. So the first one, we choose arbitrary position, okay, and insert one relation. Okay, then we insert one relation here. So another transformation, if we find a substring, which is a relation, we can delete it. Okay, so if we can transform one word to the other by finite steps of this kind of transformations,We say these two words are equivalent. 我们定义一些特殊的关系。每个关系的话呢，是一个词，所以你有限个词是吧？然后我们说两个词的话呢，它们彼此等价。如果你可以把其中的一个词通过有限步变到第二个词，那每一步的话呢，是两种基本操作中的一种。那么第一种基本变换的话，就说。你在词的任何一个部位是吧，插入一个 relation， 或者是说你在词中发现一个子串等于某一个 relation， 你把它去掉。那么如果第一个词经过这两种变换能变成第二个词，我们就说这两个词呢是彼此等价的。Okay. After introducing this one, then we define a word group. Okay, rigorously. So basically, given a set of generators, given a set of relations.Then we consider all the equivalence classes of the words, okay, generated by G, okay. Then this group is called the word group. And then we write down the word group using this formula. So the first part are the generators, the second part other relations. Okay. So if there's no relation, then the word group is called a free group. Okay. 那么引入这个关系之后的话呢，我们把这个词分类。那么所有这些词类的话呢，关于刚才定义的这个首尾相接的，依然成群。那这个群的话呢，被称为词群。那么在计算机上表示的话呢，词群有两部分，第一部分是所有的生成元，第二呢是所有的关系，是吧？就说这个群可能非常大，非常复杂，里面有无穷多个元素，但是呢它的生成元很少，那它的 relation 也非常少。如果这个群的话呢，它没有 relation，那我们就说这个群是自由生成的。那么这个曲面的基本群的话呢，就是用这个方式来表示。OK。OK, then we try to find the generator for fundamental group and the relation for fundamental group. And for surfaces, there's a very beautiful representation for fundamental group, which is called a canonical representation. So before that, we define the intersection number between curves. So here we see we have two curves on a surface, okay? One is a gamma 1 t, one is a gamma 2 tau. So they intersect at a Q point. Okay, then we define the index for this intersection point. Basically, the tangent vector for gamma 1, okay, and the tangent vector for gamma 2. So we calculate the cross product. So if the cross product is parallel to the normal, then we say the index is a positive 1, okay? But then if the cross product, okay, is against the normal direction, then we say the index is a minus 1. So it's also possible that these two curves, basically, they only superficially tangent to each other. Okay, so in this case, okay, the index equal to 0. Okay. We 们下面就是介绍如何来表达这个曲面的基本群上。曲面基本群的话有一个特别特别非常漂亮的一个结果，叫做所谓的典范基本群表示。那么我们先定义这个曲面的相交数，是吧？给定曲面上两个曲线 gamma 1 和 gamma 2， 它们在 Q 点相交，是吧？那么在交点处的两个切线量，它的差积如果和法线量平行，那我们说它这个指数是正一，是吧？如果的话呢，这个差积和这个法线量相反，那么我们说它这个 index 是负一，是吧？如果两个曲线在这个点是相切的，我们说它的 index 为零。这样的话呢，我们就为每一个点 ，OK， 每个焦点定义这个这个指标。那么给定两个圈的话呢，我们考察所有的焦点，然后呢把这个所有焦点的这个指数加起来，得到一个数，是吧？被称为这两个圈的代数相交数 ，OK。So if we have two loop, gamma sub 1, gamma sub 2, then we define the algebraic intersection number, okay, in the following way. Basically, we go through all the intersection points. For each intersection point, we calculate the index. Then we take summation for all the indices. Okay, this is called the algebraic intersection number. Okay. Then we can prove that if we homotopically deform one curve, okay, then the algebraic intersection number doesn't change. Okay, so if we deform gamma 1 from red curve to the blue curve, okay, then the intersection number doesn't change. Okay, 这幅图是说这样，就说两个曲线的代数相交数在同轮变换下不变。我们把这个红色的 gamma 1变成蓝色的 gamma 1 tilde， 是吧？这样的话，这个曲线的形状发生了改变。那开始的话呢，你看它有四个焦点，是吧？但是的话呢，这个是正一，这个是负一，是吧？它们相抵相消。然后的话呢，这蓝色的话呢，只有两个焦点。那蓝色这个代数相交数和这个红色的代数相交数实际是没变的。所以的话呢，这个代数相交数的话呢，是可以定义在曲线的同轮类上。Okay. Okay. So here we show a canonical basis for fundamental group. So here we have a genus 2 surface. Then Q is the base point, okay? Then through Q, we have a A1, okay, A2, okay, B1, B2. So if we slice the surface along those two curves, four curves, then we can slice the surface open to this octagon, okay? Suppose we trace, okay? We go along with A1 this direction, okay? We come here. Then we go with B1 here, okay? We come back here. Then we go along in the opposite direction of A1. Then we return to this point, okay? Then we start with A2, okay? 那这边的话呢，我们显示的是这个 Quigg-V2 的曲面的这个基本群的生成员，每个handle上的话有两个曲线，一个是 A1， 一个是 A2， 它一个 A1， 一个是 B1， 一个是 A2， 一个是 B2。你看，如果我们沿着这个A2 切开这个曲面的话，我们这么切开着，然后沿着它走，你保持切痕在你的右手一侧，然后的话呢，你的右侧是悬崖，左侧是曲面，是吧？ 你就沿着这 A1 这么走，走到这边的话呢，你再沿着 B1 走，走到这个曲面的后面，对吧？从后面走出来 ，OK， 从这边出来，然后呢，再走到这个角，然后再 OK， 再沿着这个 OK A2 的 inverse 走，是吧？走到那儿，再沿着这个 B2 inverse 走 ，OK， 这样的话呢，最后你可以看到，我们把整个曲面切开之后。 就得到了这样一个八边形，OK， 这个八边形的话呢，它这个一道边是 A1， B1 inverse， B1 inverse， A2 inverse， B2 inverse。 So we can cut the surface along this kind of canonical basis. Then we open the surface, we get a polygon. So this polygon has a 4 multiplied genus size, OK? So this is called a polygonal skimmer. Then the whole polygon will cover the whole surface. We can call it a fundamental domain. Okay, so this picture holds for arbitrary high genus surface. Okay, then algebraically we define this one. So suppose S is a compact oriented surface, then we find a special generators for fundamental group, which is A1 B1 A2 B2 AG BG, such that okay. AI BJ, okay, the algebraic intersection number equal to coordinate IJ, okay, then AI AJ equal to 0, BI BJ equal to 0, okay. So if you can find such kind of group, such kind of loops, then we call they are a canonical basis for the fundamental group, okay. 就是刚才这幅图的话呢，如果我们用代数来描述的话，实际是这样子。 我们为每个环饼上找到两个圈儿，然后 AIBI 是吧？然后呢，这个 AI 和 BJ 的代数相加数等于一， 如果 I 等于 J， 等于0， 如果 I 不等于 J 是吧？然后不同的 AI 呢，它们代数相加数为0，不同的 BJ 呢代数相加数也是0。对，如果你能找到这种圈的话呢，我们就把它称为曲面基本群的一组典范基底。OK， 那么从这个图上来看的话呢，这个典范基底是。 非常有规律的，但是的话呢，这个曲面上有无穷多组典范基底 ，OK， OK， then we can develop our main theorem for fundamental group. So basically, okay, the fundamental group has a canonical representation of the generator here. OK, then what does this mean? OK, so this means the following. So we see this polygonal skimmer. Then the boundary of this polygonal skimmer is A1, B1, A1 inverse, B1 inverse, A2, B2, A2 inverse, B2 inverse. Okay, so on and so forth. Then the boundary can shrink to a point. So this means that the boundary actually is a homotopically trivial. Okay, so they're equal to the unit element. So therefore, we get one relation, okay, which is A1, B1. B1 inverse, B1 inverse, okay? A2, B2, B2 inverse, B2 inverse. OK, okay, homotopic to P, okay? Okay, so this gives you the relation. 我们得到这个基本群这个表示是吧？每个 handle 上的话呢，它有一对 A 和 B， 然后呢，它只有一个 relation， 只有一个关系式。这个关系式的话，就代表刚才切开这个基本域的边界，它能缩成一个点，说的是这样一个事情。然后这基本域的话呢，它的边界的话非常有规律，每个 handle 会产生一个四个词是吧？那这个四个词的话呢，用这个理括号表示是吧 ？A1 B1，代表就是这个 ，OK。这是一个基本定理是吧？那我们来证明一下这个定理，然后再看这个如何算这个东西是吧 ？Okay, so here we show another example which is also canonical. Okay, so here you see A1 here and B1 here, they have one intersection number here, and A2 here, okay, B2 here, they have another intersection here. Okay.So then this shows that the canonical representation for the fundamental group is not unique. In fact, there are infinite many such kind of canonical representations. Okay. So it will be very interesting to find the one with the special geometric properties, okay, such as the shortest. Okay. 那这边的话呢，我们显示的是另外一组这个典范基底。我们看这个 A1 和 B1 只有一个焦点，然后 A2 和 B2 只有一个焦点，它们之间的话彼此没有焦点。那么原来的话，我们说每个 handle 实际代表一个洞，是吧？那这边我们看有这 H1 是个洞 ，H2 是个洞。其实的话呢，整个外面空间 H3 也是个洞，是吧？我们不能说这个 H3 不是洞，是吧？所以你看这个 A2 和 B2 实际上它围绕的是 H3 这个洞 ，OK？ 所以这说明这个洞这个概念的话呢是人类比较人为的一个概念，它并不是本质的一个拓扑概念，对于曲面而言是吧 ？OK， 如果我们要想定义什么是确切的洞是吧？必须要加上这个嵌入 R3 这个东西是吧 ？OK， so there's some kind of fundamental theorem saying suppose we have two fundamental groups, okay, then they are isomorphic. We can map first one to the second one, the two surfaces.Homeomorphic to each other. Okay, so the proof actually, the idea for proof is straightforward. Basically, you can find a canonical basis for both of them. Then we slice the surface along the basis. Okay, then we get this 4G GaN. Okay, then we can map those two 4G GaN. Okay, and build the homeomorphism between them. Okay, but then when we do this, we need to pay attention to the consistency among the boundary conditions.Basically, 就说有一个基本定理，它是说，如果两个这个紧的可以定向的曲面，它们基本群彼此同构，那么的话，它们拓扑等价，存在一个拓扑同胚在它们之间，就证明的话呢，非常非常 straightforward。就说你通过给定这个群的话呢，可以把它们变成这个典范形式，然后通过典范基底的话呢，把它切成这个 polygonal schema 是吧？然后你在平面上，找到它们两个平面 polygon 之间的映射，但一定要小心这个边界条件一定要设置好，是吧？就这边是 alpha one， 这个，到这边是 a one inverse， 是吧？这边是 alpha one inverse。所以如果你要想这个求两个高可曲面之间的注册，那么的话呢，实际这个证明也给了你他们计算算法，是吧 ？Actually, this proof gives you a computational method to find a mapping.Or retraction between high-genus surfaces. If you can find a canonical basis, then you slice them to this polygonal schema. Then you're using a planar map, like harmonic map. You can easily find that the homeomorphism between two surfaces. Okay. Actually, in computer vision, people really do this way. Okay. So, 在计算机视觉中，这个拓扑复杂曲面的注册的确用的是这种方法，是吧？所以，但是这个困难就在于如何找到这个 canonical basis.Okay, then how can we prove this fundamental theorem? Okay, so just now, so this is the fundamental theorem about a fundamental group. Okay, then we prove it using something called a Surford Van Kampen. Okay, so basically, suppose we have a big space M, then we decompose this one into two subspaces, U and V. So the intersection is W. So U, V, and W, all of them are path connected. Okay. Okay, then we calculate the fundamental group for each part, for each component. So this is the fundamental group for U, that for V, that for W. Then we can combine, okay, all the generator relation here to get the fundamental group for the original space. So basically, we copy the generator from U here. We copy the generator from V here. Okay, we copy the relation from U here. Copy the relation from V here. But the intersection part, okay, the relation for intersection, okay, do not contribute anything. But the generator contribute a lot. So each generator actually has a one representation in U, also have another representation in V. Those two representations are equivalent. Therefore, each generator here give you a new relation, okay? So then this give you a way to calculate fundamental group for complicated shapes using divide and conquer. 这个定理的话呢非常有用，它实际是给了一个分而治之的一个方法，就说你给了我一个比较大的一个流形，我把它切成两块，然后的话呢U 是一块 ，V 是一块，然后它们相交的话是个 W， 它们，然后呢，我们分别算 U 和 V 的这个基本群是吧？然后呢，再算它们相交部分的基本群，但要求的话呢，这个 U、V、W 都是道路连通的，这点要注意是吧？在实际计算中 ，OK。然后的话呢，我们通过这个三个小的基本群，可以拼成原来这个流行的大的基本群是吧？我们只要把这个。U 的这个生成源，copy过来是吧 ？V 的生成源 copy 过来，把 U 的这个关系呢 copy 过来是吧？把 V 的关系 copy 过来，然后呢，这个相交部分的这个所有的关系的话，把它扔掉，不管。但是的话呢，这个相交部分的每一个生成源，它既在 U 里面，也在 V 里面，所以它在 U 中有一个表示，在 V 中也有一个表示，这两个表示的话呢，是彼此等价的。所以的话呢，这个相交部分的每个生成源会得到一个新的关系 ，OK， 这边的每个生成源会得到一个关系。那用这种方法的话，你可以分而治之，把一个复杂的空间分解成分成两半，每半再分成两半，是吧？然后这样的话，递归的就可以算出来原来空间的这个基本群。所以这个方法对于算法设计是非常本质的 ，OK。So here we will use when Kappen surfed method to prove okay the fundamental group representation. So then we define connected sum concept first. Suppose we have two towers, okay? So this is one tower, another one. Then we remove a disk from the first one, remove a disk from the second one. Then we glue the boundary of those two disks. Given the point here, you find a point there. So after gluing, basically you will get this genus 2 surface. Then this operation is called connected sum. Okay. So 这边的话呢，我们给出这个曲面的一种构造方法，叫做连通和是吧？或者连接和。就说你有两个曲面，然后的话呢，你从第一个曲面上抠掉一个小圆盘，从第二个小曲面上曲面上你抠掉另外一个小圆盘，然后第一个小圆盘的边界的话呢是一个圈儿 ，Okay。那第二小圆盘呢，边界呢也是个圈儿啊。那圈和圈之间的话呢，你找到一个映射啊。这样的话，你把这个圈上这一个点和对应的点给粘起来，看着是同一个点，粘起来啊。粘之后的话呢，你就得到一个封闭的曲面。这个曲面的话就是窥格为二是吧？这个操作的话被称为连通和 ，OK。然后曲面论的话呢，有一个基本定理，就说所有的这个紧的可定向的这个曲面。可以看成是很多 torus 的联动核 ，OK。如果你有一个 torus， 它有很多 genus， 每个 genus 的话可以看成是加上去一个 torus，OK，、okay? 这样是吧？当然不可定向的曲面的话，那我们要加一个特殊的东西啊，这个摄影空间，我们现在可以不用太考虑这个情况是吧 ？So this is a very fundamental theorem in surface topology. So given compact oriented closed surfaces.It can be decomposed as a connected sum of a bunch of torus. Okay, so each genus corresponding to one torus, you're just adding a lot of torus together. Okay, then you form the original surface. Okay, Okay, then we try to understand the fundamental group for torus. So here we see a torus, and AB is a pair of canonical bases, and P, okay, is the base point. We slice the surface along A and B, we get a planar rectangle. Then the size for the rectangle is A, B, A inverse, B inverse. So here we have a red curve. You'll see the red curve here. This red curve is mapped to a planar curve on this rectangle. Then you'll see that this red curve can deform, okay, to this edge A and B. So therefore, the red curve gamma equal to A multiplied B. Okay, also here we see that this rectangle, okay, the boundary can shrink to a point. The boundary of this rectangle is AB, A inverse, B inverse. So this gives you the fundamental group for torus is given by this way, okay? Okay, then suppose you have arbitrary closed curve, okay? Then the first, okay, we can deform the curve such that the intersection of the curve with A or B, okay, equal to P. Then we separate the whole curve to many, many segments, okay? So for each segment on gamma I, it starts and ends at a P. The interior of gamma I has no intersection with A or B, okay? Then the gamma I is generated by AB or A inverse or B inverse, okay? Then we can write down the original curve using a sequence, okay, of generators. 这一页呢是证明这个 拓扑环带它的基本权的话呢，是由 AB 生成，然后只有一个 relation AB A inverse B inverse 那么我们把这个曲面呢，沿着 AB 切开，然后撑开撑到平面上，我们得到平面的一个四边形。这个四边形的话呢，四个角点是 P 是吧？然后呢，它的边界的话呢是 AB 是吧？然后 A 逆和 B 逆，OK。 然后的话呢，这个边界的话能设成一个点。 所以我们就得到了这个关系式，是吧？那么怎么证明所有的圈都是由 AB 生成呢？那么第一步的话呢，如果这个圈和 AB 有交点，我们先同轮变换这个圈，使得呢这个圈和这个 AB 所有的交点都在 P 上。然后呢，我们把这个圈分解成一系列的小圈，分解成 gamma one、 gamma two 到 gamma k。那么每个 gamma i 呢，它从 P 点出发到 P 点结束。 但是在中间的话呢，它和 AB 没有其他的交点，那这就意味着这个 gamma i 的话呢，可以被用到这个长方形的内部，然后它和边界没有交点，只跟角点有交点是吧？然后的话呢，它肯定是从某个角点出发到另外一个角点终止是吧？所以它可以 deform 到这个四边形的某个边上，你这个所有的边的话呢都是 AB、 A 逆、 B 逆它们的这个乘积是吧？所以的话呢，每个 gamma i 呢？ 可以用 AB 来生成，那原来大 gamma 的话呢，是这些 gamma i 的乘积，所以大 gamma 的话呢，也是由 AB 来生成，这样就证明了这个 torus 它的基本群的确是 AB 生成的，有一个 relation，OK， 所以这是第一步。那么第二步的话呢，我们这个 torus 我抠掉一个圆盘 ，OK， 抠掉一个圆盘的话呢，相当于在这平面长方形上你抠掉一个洞，是吧？ 你把这个洞扩大，扩得非常大，把这内部全都蚕食掉，那最后剩下的是什么呢？剩下就是两个圈，一个圈是 A， 一个圈是 B， 实际是个图上。那图的这个基本群是自由生成的，那么图的这个基本群就是 AB， 但没有 relation， 因为任何圈的话，它要想设成一个点，一定要有一个面积嘛，有个二维的东西是吧？那这个一维的图上没有二维的 patch， 所以它没法生成一个点。这样我们证明了，就说 Towers 抠掉一个点之后的话呢，它的基本群是 AB. So this picture shows that suppose we have a torus, then we punch a disk, we remove a disk. Okay. Then we slice the surface along AB, get a planar rectangle, and this is the hole in the middle. We can enlarge the hole, okay, to exhaust all the 2D area. Okay. So the only part left is a one-dimensional graph. Okay, which are two loops, A and B, has one intersection point. And any loop on this 1D graph cannot shrink to a point. So therefore, the fundamental group for this guy has no relation. So therefore, the fundamental group for this graph is freely generated by A and B. Okay. So using those two result, we can prove our theorem using induction. So now let's see a genus 2 case. So for genus 2, we subdivide to T1 is this part, okay, T2 is this part. The intersection is a gamma between them. Okay. And then by previous lemma, we know the fundamental group for T1 is A1, B1. The fundamental group for the T2 is A2, B2. Then the fundamental group for the intersection actually generated by gamma itself. So we know the fundamental group of three components. Then using the Van Kempen surfeit, we will combine the generator, this one, and then this guy will give us the relation. Okay. So then we copy generator A1, B1 here, copy A2, B2 here. Okay, then this gamma has a two representation. So in T1, gamma is represented this way. In T2, okay, gamma is represented this way. So they are equivalent, we get one relation. Okay, so then this gives you the proof for genus 2 case. 那这边的话呢, 我们先看这个奎格维尔的曲面如何证明，是吧？ 那就说我们拦腰砍一刀，把它分解成两部分。 一边有一个handle，是吧？ 然后这个刀痕的话呢，是一个圈，是伽马。 那么这边的话是一个 donut， 是个轮胎去掉一个disc， 这边也是个轮胎去掉一个disc。 所以根据刚才这个原理，它的基本群的话呢是 A1 B1 生成的，它的基本群呢是 A2 B2。 那伽马的基本群的话呢，它是圈嘛，圈的基本群就是圈重复很多次，是吧？是由 伽马 生成。然后根据那个 Van Kempen surfeit 定理的话呢。 那么 T1 这个并上 T2 等于原来的奎格维尔的曲面是吧？它的生成源等于这两个生成源的并，然后的话呢，它的 relation 是由这个生成源诱导的。那 gamma 的话呢，它既属于 T1 也属于 T2。那么在 T1 中的话呢，OK gamma 呢等于这个四边形的边界，OK， 所以 gamma 等于 A inverse B inverse。同理的话 ，gamma 在 T2 中，OK 也可以这么 write down 是吧？ 所以的话呢，这个 gamma 有两个表示，这两个表示彼此等价，拼在一块的话得到一个关系式，这样就证明在奎格维尔的情况下，那个主定也是对的。然后我们可以自然用这个数学归纳法证明对于任意奎格积它都是对的，是吧？大家可以做一作业啊，把这个严格的证明一下。就假设呢，G等于一的情况下是G减一的情况下是对的，然后你再增加一个 handle，OK， 那么的话呢，用同样的 argument。 So therefore, for general case, we can use a mathematical deduction method, induction method. So assume the theorem is true for G minus one, then we adding one more handle, okay. Then for the first part, we know the fundamental group already. For the second part, we know the fundamental group. For the intersection part, we can write down using Van Kempen surfeit. We can combine everything together to get the solution. Okay, so 这样的话呢，我们就证明了曲面基本群的这个典范表示。那么如何计算呢 ？Okay, so then we come to the computational part. So we have built the theoretic foundation. Then how do we really compute it? Okay, So the first step, we need to compute something called a cut graph. So cut graph actually is a special graph on the surface. So when you remove this special graph. The whole surface become to a topological disk, okay? 就是第一步的话呢，我们要算所谓的切图 cut graph 是吧？那就说你这个曲面上，有这样一个切图，把它切下去之后的话呢，曲面可以展成一个 top 圆盘 ，okay? 这是 cut graph 的定义是吧 ？Okay, so maybe I can show you one demo for this one. Okay. So here I'm going to show you some real demo for computing the cut graph. Okay. So suppose we have a genus 2 surface. Okay. So this is a genus 2 surface. Okay. Then on computer, we're using a triangle mesh to represent it. Okay. So we will cover how can we generate such kind of triangulation. Okay. So this is an input. Okay. Then using our computational method, you will find a special graph. So the red curve here showing the cut graph. So basically, if we slice the surface along the cut graph, then we get a topological disk, okay? So the graph actually is along the triangulation edges, okay? 这个曲面的话沿着切图切开的话呢就得到一个 disk 就得到一个单连通的是吧，亏个为零的曲面，然后只有一条边界。怎么算呢？就是你可以想象这个曲面上布满了干草，然后你随便选一点开始放火，这火焰的话呢就在曲面上蔓延开来，是吧？这越长越大，然后的话这个火焰的前缘是吧，会在一些地方相遇，相遇的地方的火势就会熄灭。 那么火焰熄灭的地方，给了我们这个 cut graph， 所以这是这个算法的一个很直观的描述，是吧？我们叫火烧法。当然，在数学上也叫你从一点出发，发出测地线，这个测地线往前走，那么越走越大，这个测地线的前缘会彼此相遇，相遇的地方呢被称为 cut locus。Okay， so basically， we can imagine that we pick one point on the surface， then we issue geodesic。 Okay, so the geodesic will go to go different direction. Okay, the wave front for the geodesic will meet somewhere. Okay, so when the geodesic wave front meets, okay, we get a cut locus. So the cut locus basically is the cut graph. 这火烧的时候的话呢，它只能均匀的往外拓展，然后它烧过的区域的话呢，肯定是拓扑圆盘，它没办法跳跃。所以这样的话呢，直观上我们保证。 这样你拿开之后的话呢，得到的确是一个拓扑圆盘，并且这个算法呢穷尽了所有的二维的面积，是吧？剩下的就是一维的图，所以这是给算法一个直观描述，是吧？那么我们现在用这个计算机语言来说一下，是吧？OK， so the computation is as follows. So given a closed triangle mesh as input, the output is a cut graph. So first we compute the dual mesh. M bar of the input mesh. So what does this mean for dual mesh? Basically, suppose we have a triangulation, that's the triangle mesh, okay? So this is the original mesh. Then we treat each face as one point, okay? Okay, then we connect the face centers, okay? Then each vertex become to a cell, okay? Each edge converted to an edge, okay? And each face become to a new vertex. We get another mesh, okay? Another polygonal structure, a polyhedral structure, which is called a dual mesh. Okay, once we have a dual mesh, we compute a spanning tree, T bar, for the dual mesh. Okay, then we find all such kind of edges, okay, on the original mesh, such that the dual of this edge, okay, doesn't belong to the spanning tree. Okay, so this gives you the cut graph. Okay, so this cut graph 的一个算法非常简单，就说你的输入的话呢是个三角网格，然后我们要算它的一个对偶，所谓对偶的话就说我们算每个三角形的中心，然后的话呢把这些中心的话就连接起来，然后每个边就得到一个对偶的边，原来三角网格上的每个顶点变成一个面儿。 然后的话呢，原来三角网格上每个面变成一个顶点，每个边呢还变成一个边，这样我们得到了另外一个m 把是吧？有了 m 把的话呢，我们把它看成一个 graph， 算它的生成数是吧 ？t 把，然后呢，我们看这样的边就是这些边的话呢不在这个 t 把上，然后这些边的队友边在原来的三角网格上，构成一个图就是 cut graph，OK。 这算法非常的 straightforward， 也比较高效，是吧？So once you have the cut graph, we can calculate, the basis for fundamental group. Okay， 就说当你算了 cut graph 之后的话呢，那么第二步你要算这个基本群的生成源，是吧？就是那些圈儿。OK， 这些圈儿的话，实际就相对容易算了。我们来看啊。 Okay, so all the computation here is in real time. So given a GDS2 surface, okay, triangle mesh, we compute the cut graph. Okay, then from cut graph, we calculate the basis for fundamental group. So this is a loop one, okay. Then this loop two, okay. So you'll see this is definitely a loop, but okay, looks kind of complicated. So this method doesn't give you canonical basis, but give you a valid group, a valid basis, okay. Third one, okay. And the fourth one, okay. So this for genus two, okay. Then we try a more complicated case. We try genus three. Okay, so the input mesh is a genus three, has a, you'll see, has a three handles here. Okay, that's a triangle mesh. Then we calculate a cut graph using the method we described, okay. Looks very complicated, okay. 这边我们用火烧法来算出它的一个切图上，有了切图之后的话呢，我们再算这个基本群的基底。So you see, this is one loop, okay. There should be six, right? Each hand has two. This is the second one, highly irregular, okay. Because here we only consider topology, without consider, okay, the geometry. We can shorten them to be geodesic, but that'll be another thing, okay. Three, okay, four, okay, a five, okay, So this one you see, circle two handles, okay. Okay, once we have a cut graph, then we can calculate, okay, the group basis using the following method. So the input is a triangle mesh, okay. Then the output is a set of generators for the fundamental group. So basically, first we're using previous method to compute the cut graph. Then we compute a spanning tree for the cut graph. Then so the cut graph remove the spanning tree, there will be some edges left. So for each lefting edge, we union with the tree, we will get a unique loop. So then all such kind of loop form a generators, okay, for the fundamental group. Okay, so 这是算法，就是说第一步的话呢，你先算它的切图，然后这个切图呢也是一个图是吧？那你要算这个图的一个生成数，那么这个切图去掉这个数之后会剩下一些边，每个边的话你加到数上，它肯定会生成一个圈，然后的话呢，每个边生成一个圈，你把这些圈都收集起来，这些圈的话呢，就是原来这个三角网格的。 它的一个生成源，基本性的生成源啊。那么大家可以用这von Kapp-Seifert定理来证明这个算法是对的。OK，这个作为家庭作业了，大家可以回去思考。你当然也可以编制程序，这程序不难写。写完之后的话，那你要想为什么这个程序是对的呀？那用我们今天讲这个所有的一个von Kapp-Seifert已经可以证明了。OK， 那么呢，how can we get a relation? So relation is more complicated. So here basically. You compute a cut graph, okay, you compute a spanning tree, and then the cut graph remove spanning tree, you get oriented edges, E1, E2, to EK. Okay, so each EI here corresponding to a generator gamma I. Okay, then we slice the surface along the cut graph, we obtain a polygonal schema or fundamental domain, M bar. Then we consider the boundary of M bar is a loop. Then we traverse gamma here. Okay, then we set a word W equal to empty at the beginning. So once we encounter the EI here, either in the same orientation or in the inverse orientation, we add gamma I positive or minus one to the word. Okay, we repeat this process. Eventually, we will get a word. That word is the relation. Okay, 那这个基本群的话呢，它有两部分，一部分是生成源，第二部分是关系，是吧？你如何算这个关系呢？ 那第一步的话呢，我们先算这个三角网格的这个 cut graph， gamma， 有了 gamma 之后的话呢，我们算它的生成数是吧？spanning tree，gamma 减掉这个数之后的话呢，剩下一些边儿，这个边儿都是有定向的，这个定向的边儿的话呢，和这个对应这个基底的一个圈儿正向相同。然后呢，我们把这个三角网格沿着这个cut graph 切开，切完之后的话呢，你得到一个基本域是吧？ 或者 polygonal schema， 它是一个 top 圆盘，看它的边界，它的边界的话呢，实际上是围着这个 gamma 走了两次 ，OK， 然后的话呢把它的边界继承啊继承这个小伽马，然后的话呢我们在这个伽马上这个行走是吧，依次行走，每当我们碰到这个 EI 是吧，这个 EI 是属于这里面，我们就加上一个伽马 A， 如果碰见 EI 的反向，我们加上伽马 A 的反向，那我们从起点走，从起点走回来之后的话呢，回到起点你就会得到一个词，这个词的话呢就是这个基本权的关系，由此的话呢我们得到了生成源，得到关系，就得到了这个基本权的一个表示，但这个表示的话呢并不是 canonical 的，并不是典范的，那要算典范的话那个比例要复杂一些。 OK, so basically so these three methods together give you a representation for the fundamental group using a word group, but this representation is not canonical, okay, and so that's the hard part. So computing a one representation is a linear time, okay, but verify whether two representations are equivalent is NP hard, okay, so that's why computational method in general is NP, okay.就说这三个算法 ，OK， 这个切图，然后生成源，还有关系式，是吧？加在一块儿，给出封闭曲面的一个基本权的表示。但是这个表示的话呢，往往并不是典范的，它比典范要复杂。那么，因此的话呢，你得到这个基本权的一个表示，这个计算的时间复杂度是线性的 ，OK， 非常简单。但是的话呢，就是同一个群它有不同的表示。你碰到这两种表示是不是彼此等价，这个算法是 NP 难的问题，这也是为什么这个计算拓扑本质上来讲大多数问题都是 NP 难的问题。 OK， 好， So this gives you the first part for the fundamental group. Now the second part is a covering space, so we may not have enough time to cover that, so we will see how far we can go. So here you see that we flatten okay the kitten to a planar rectangle, then we can repeat this rectangle to tessellate the whole plane. So in other words, we can build a mapping from the whole plane to this kitten. Then for each point on a kitten, we can find a neighborhood. Okay, then we find one preimage for that neighborhood. Okay, so the restriction of this mapping between those two neighborhoods is one-to-one, onto, and continuous. So in that case, we say,the whole plane cover this torus. Okay, so this is the covering space for this base space. Okay, so 这边的话呢，我们显示一个覆盖空间的概念。就说我们周期性的把这个小猫铺到平面上，是吧？然后的话呢，那么这个平面上任何一个点，你可以把它用回到小猫上相应的点。你这个映射的话呢，有这样一个特点，就说小猫上你随便取一个顶点。然后找它的一个小淋域，这个淋域的原像的话有无穷多个 ，OK， 但这无穷多个这个原像的话呢，彼此是分离的，然后你选定其中的一个 OK 原像，然后的话呢，这个刚才这个映射的话限制在这个小区域到这个小区域上，它是同胚的，是一一映射，并且是 onto， 然后并且是光滑的，那么这种情况下的话呢，我们说这个空间。是这个空间的一个覆盖空间，这是底空间，是吧？然后这个映射的话呢，被称为投影映射。就说总体上看的话呢，这个投影的话呢是多对一的，但局部上看的话呢，它是一对一的，那这是它基本的意思，是吧 ？OK， 好的呢，we can rigorously define what's meaningful covering space. So given a two topological spaces S2 and S.And a continuous map P from S2 to S. Okay, this mapping is a surjective. And for each point, okay, on S, we can find a neighborhood. The preimage of this neighborhood is a disjoint union for open sites. The restriction of this P on each UI tilde is a local homeomorphism. So in this case, we say S2 to P is a covering space for S, and P is called a projection. Okay.Then we can define a back transformation. So if we come back to this image, so if we translate the whole plane from one polygonal schema to another one, so we shift from this point to this point, okay? This point to this point. Then this mapping doesn't change the projection, okay? So then all such kind of mapping, basically we shift the whole plane, the projection doesn't change, the mapping doesn't change projection, is called back transformation, okay, or covering map, okay. 这边我们可以看一个特殊的映射，就是说我们把整个平面错动，对吧？错动之后的话呢，它把这只小猫用到这只小猫呢，这只猫用到这只猫，就是它把它的其中的一个 polygonal schema 变成另外一个，整体发生错动，是吧？那这个整体错动的话呢，这个猫鼻子还用到猫鼻子，是吧？这个猫耳朵还用到猫耳朵尖上，那这个整体错动并不影响这个投影映射，那保持这种投影映射不变，所有这种整体错动的话被称为甲板映射，或者就叫覆盖映射，覆盖变换，是吧？ OK, so that's the definition here. Suppose we have a tau, okay, which is the automorphism of S tilde, okay, then tau composed with a projection equal to the projection, okay, such kind of mapping, okay, is called a DAG transformation. Then we can show that all the DAG transformations form another group, which is called a covering group, or denoted as a DAG S tilde.Okay, then we can write down, the relation between the fundamental group of covering space and the fundamental group for the base space using this formula, okay? So this is the fundamental group for the base space, and this is the fundamental group for the covering space. Then the projection push forward,okay, this group, okay, to a subgroup for the base fundamental group. And the quotient group is isomorphic to the DAG transformation, okay, for the covering space, okay? So this actually, using algebraic relation, gave you, okay, the topological relation, okay? 那这边的话呢，我们看这个覆盖空间有一个基本群，底空间有个基本群，然后呢，覆盖空间还有一个甲板映射群，这三个群之间的话是有确定的联系的。那么这个投影映射的话呢，把覆盖空间的基本群并成了底空间基本群的一个子群。那么这个商群的话呢，和这个覆盖空间的这个甲板映射群是同构的。OK， 所以这个式子很优美，是吧？所以这是一个典型的例子，如何用代数来表达特谱。OK。So this gives you a beautiful example for how can we use an algebra to represent a topology, okay? But then there is a very special, very beautiful, useful covering space, which is called universal covering space. So universal covering space meaning, so if the space is simply connected, meaning the fundamental group is only one element, then we say this S tilde is a universal covering, okay? Then if we plug in to this equation, so this part become to E,So therefore, we get, okay, the fundamental group for the base space is isomorphic to the DAG transformation of the universal covering space, okay? 有一个特殊的这个覆盖空间叫做万有覆盖。那么万有覆盖呢，它是单联通的，就说它上面所有的圈都能缩成一个点。那在这种情况下的话呢，根据这个定理，这个分母为 E 是吧？所以我们就得到底空间的基本群。和这个覆盖空间的这个甲板变换群是同构的 ，OK， 所以我们刚才看这个例子上，这个空间的话呢，所有的圈都能缩成点，所以呢它是单联通的，所以呢它呢是这个小猫的万有覆盖 ，OK。So here we see a more complicated case. So this is Genius 2 surface. actually here we show this surface can be covered by this hyperbolic space. So this is the universal current space for this guy. This is really hard to imagine at the beginning. maybe I can show okay, some code here. You'll see this is the base space, okay? Then we find one set of canonical bases. So you'll see the canonical bases. Okay, then we slice the surface along the canonical bases. We will get one polygonal schema, okay? Like the one showing here, okay? So you'll see the mapping from this one So this one is one-to-one. For arbitrary triangle here, you can find a corresponding triangle there. The mapping is one-to-one except the boundary, okay? Then we can glue, okay, this polygonal schema consistently. Suppose this is A1. Then we get another copy, we glue with A1 minus. Then together, we can tessellate the whole disk, okay? So here I show, we use more than 20 or 30 copies, okay? So here you see different color representing different copies. Although they look, the size look different, but in fact, if we use a hyperbolic metric, they are very, they're just equal to each other. Then if you zoom in, you can see a very small structure there. So if you turn on, okay, the triangulation, okay, you see actually the triangle is really dense. So each of them can cover the original surface, okay? 这边的话呢，我们显示的是一个特别费解的情况，是吧？这个远离人们的日常生活经验，就说给这个高规格的曲面的话呢，那么我们可以呢用这个这个典范基底把它切开成一个八边形，是吧？然后的话呢，我们把这些八边形粘起来，比如说这个边是 A1， 这个边是 A1 inverse， 粘完之后的话呢，上面配一个上体度量，是吧？你可以不停的粘下去，所以的话呢，每个顶点处的话，你看粘了八个 copy。每个顶点处粘八个 copy， 所以这是第零圈，这第一圈上，跟第二圈，所以往后走的话呢，这个每圈它这个 copy 的数目的话是指数级增长，但你可以证明，你不停粘下去之后的话呢，它最后会整个覆盖整个 open 的这个单位圆盘，所以的话呢，这个单位圆盘就是这个曲面的万有覆盖空间 ，OK， 但这个问题非常难以计算，为什么？因为它这个 size 的话是指数级减小。所以的话呢，你往外只要走出超过两三成，就完全超过机器精度，所以机器上就没法算了。所以这个双曲几何 ，OK， 还有高规格的这个曲面为什么困难？是吧？一方面是因为它这个 storage 这个 requirement 本身就是指数级增长，然后的话呢，基础机器精度的话很难保证，所以计算错误非常困难。从这个角度讲 ，OK。So here we show the universal current space for high genus surface, and we encounter big trouble for numerical accuracy because the size decreases exponentially fast. So we cannot go too further, okay? Then how can we find a reliable method to compute such kind of hyperbolic tessellation? It's really challenging. So that's why computational topology is highly non-trivial, basically, okay? So then, so here we have one theorem to show the existence for universal current space. Okay, so due to the time limit, I will leave this for next lecture. 那这边的话，我们给了一个严格证明，证明这个万有覆盖空间的存在性。但这个证明特别抽象，在下次我们讲，大家可以去看笔记，是吧？它基本想法就是说，我固定 Q 点，然后考虑这个曲面上所有的路径。这路径的终点的话，不见得是 Q， 它不是 loop。然后所有路径的同轮类构成一个抽象的空间，那个所有路径同类构成的空间就是这个曲面的万有覆盖空间。所以它这个证明手法的非常抽象，但是一旦你懂了之后的话是非常有用的。大家回去看一看，然后下堂课我们讲这细节。OK， then how can we compute universal current space？ OK， we can give you some computational method。So here, suppose the input is a closed triangle mesh, then the output is a finite portion for the universal current space. So basically, we calculate a cut graph gamma or m. Then, because this is a graph, we can divide it into nodes and the segments. The segment is S1, S2, to Sk here. Okay. Then we slice m along the cut graph to get a fundamental domain m bar. Okay. We initialize the current space using m bar.Then on the boundary of this guy, we choose one segment, SI. Then we glue, okay, another copy, M bar, with the current space, okay, along SI and inverse SI. So the inverse of SI belongs to the boundary of this copy, SI belongs to the boundary of this copy. Then we glue them together. Then we trace the boundary for the new current space. So if in the boundary there are two adjacent segments, okay, so I sub i plus one, so they are inverse to each other, then we glue those two segments together. We repeat this process, okay, until we cannot find such kind of adjacent segments anymore. Then we repeat step four and step five. We can get a finite portion for the universal current space. Okay. 那这边的话呢，给出这个万有覆盖空间的一种构造性方法。我们知道这个万有覆盖空间本身是无穷大的，所以我们只能计算它一个有限的区域，是吧？那么第一步的话呢，我是把这个M 上的一个切图先算出来，算完之后的话，因为它是个图嘛，它可以被分解成很多段，是吧？很多边编辑成 S1 到 SK 和很多 node 很多顶点，是吧？所以它每个边的话呢是。 一系列原来小边的一个组合是吧，但是是有定向的。然后呢，我们把这个 M 沿着这个 cut graph 切开，得到一个基本域 M 八，然后把这个覆盖空间先初始化，它是一个拷贝上 M 八。然后的话呢，我们在这个覆盖空间的边界上随便找一个 segment SI， 然后的话呢，我们得到一个新的拷贝 M 八的一个新的拷贝，把这个新的拷贝呢和当前那个 common space 粘起来。 那么在 M 8上取这个 SI， 在M 2上取 SI， 在 M 8的边界上取 SI inverse， 把它们俩联合起来。联合之后的话呢，我们在最终这个覆盖空间的边界，它的边界上有可能出现相邻的两个 segment， 这两个 segment 的话彼此是相反的，是互逆的。这样的话呢，我们把这个相邻的 segment 再接起来。 然后呢，再不停的重复这个过程，直到稳定，是吧？这样的话，你得到了一个更新之后的这 current space。然后的话呢，我们重复 step four step five， 直到得到这个 portion 足够大，到那时候我们就停止，是吧？OK， 所以这就给出了这个万有覆盖空间的一种构造方法。OK， 这个因为时间的关系的话，今天我们就讲到这里是吧？然后这个我们下周六周日再接着讲。OK， 所以我们今天就停到这里是吧？好，那邱先生您要不要总结一下？现在您还没有 mute 的，能不能打开 microphone？
好。 好，今天讲的很好。这个关于fundamental group 的算法，其实蛮有意思。这个应当有很多不同的算法，我觉得这个surface 比较简单一点，我们对 fundamental group 很清楚。但是高维，尤其三维空间，我想以后会要用到，是做这个 fundamental group 可能要不同的方法。 不过 ，in any case， 在那个 surface 上面有个 graph， 就这个 graph 怎么 capture 整个 surface 的 topologies， 我觉得是应当很有用的。这个怎么找个 canonical graph 啊，这个变成 combinatorial， 我想有用。同时，这个以后要讲到的，在每一个 loop， 就是每一个 fundamental group 的 element 里边呢。 要算他们的 period， 所谓这个 definite form 在那边的绕一圈，它的 integral 是多大，这是相当重要的问题，以后大概会讲到了。不过这个跟 fundamental group 有密切的关系，好吗？今天讲的很好，谢谢。
好，谢谢邱先生。好，谢谢大家。那我们今天到这里结束。好，谢谢。